All right. This video is for those people out there that want to know more about the Bose L1 Model S. The 1S is in the middle of the Model 2 and the compact. The difference is the compact has 6 speakers. This has 12. And the Model 2 has 24. Now, I never understood why they did 24 speakers all the way down to the floor. It makes no sense to have speakers down there. So instead of getting one Model 2, I got 2 1Ss. They fit in a bag as small as this. And of course the sub. I have both the B2 and the B1s. This is for smaller venues when you don't want to carry much. You don't need a ton of, you know, bass. It's very small, compact. the one I did purchase it came with the B2. The B2 is equivalent to 4 of these. Focus, there you go. 4 of these, which is a considerable amount. Because if you wanted to hook up 4 of these to a Model 2, you would need an additional amplifier, which costs like $300, $400 actually. Plus you would have 4 of these to carry around. So when they came out with the B2 bass module, there's a switch on the back of it. You can toggle it, you know, minus, mid, or plus. So minus is equal to 1 of these. Mid is equal to 2, and supposedly plus is equal to 4 of these by the sheer size of it. I can't show you the video right now because the B2s are packed up right now. One thing is different. You don't have the output that you do. I think technically inside this thing is basically the exact same as the Model 2. Except they left off the jack for the output so you could power more amps. And the reason they did that is because they don't want you unbalancing the system and putting too much bass. And to be honest with you, you really don't need it. It's loud. Rocks the house, and I'm sure the neighbors can hear that. I gotta be real careful. This is for the tone match engine here, which I did not purchase because I'm a DJ. It's mostly for guitars and bands and stuff. That was only halfway, by the way. If you're using one of these, which you can because you have a line array, you'll notice that it is a balanced line in, on also unbalanced quarter inch. If you wanted to run in an iPod, though, you might have a problem, and because it's not a stereo input like it is on the compact, has the little RCA left and right in. You don't want to get an adapter and take the left and right and just plug it into that. It will cancel out the left and right will basically fight each other because they're basically being fed into the same system, and it'll give you like a weird sound, and it will not get you a full range of your sound, so something you have to keep in mind. However, there's a solution to that, and I found this little device here. It is a line level combiner, and what is you can do is you can put 2 XLR ins, and then out comes XLR, and then I have the XLR running into that. So this actually has transformers in it that keep the signals separate from each other, so that way it doesn't cancel each other. And it, basically it would sound something similar to this, like a phase. Not that bad though, but the point is this box allows you to change the phase, reverse or not. Also has a ground lift, which is very useful. I think I paid like $100 or less for this, or $50. I don't know what it was. I found it on Amazon. One thing I noticed is if you put it near here, because the transformer's in it, it will pick up the hum from the digital power supply. Now, speaking of the power supply, the base of this unit, focus, is the amplifier and the power supply for the speaker. So basically, you have your stands here. This is your empty column, and then you have your line array here. nothing else. No other wires running. You basically use two wires. Your power and your speaker and input. There's three wires. That's it. Unless, you know, let's use a tone match. In here, there is a couple of fans that are actually keeping the unit cold. These little wings actually fold up. And they fold up so it fits in this nice little bag. I have not been able to really give it a good whirl. But the secret of Bose, and I mean this is no lie, there are people that set these things up and walked an entire football stadium, and the volume is still, it's decreased, but nowhere near as much as a regular speaker. So, and I've done experiments myself where I've sat next to the speaker, and it was at 80 decibels, and I walked maybe a couple, 300 feet away, and it was still about 80 decibels. And the reason it is because you could see inside, there's a speakers, 12 little speakers articulated, meaning they're aiming in different directions, and it's very hard to see. One faces left, one faces right, and then and what it does is it gives the room a complete coverage. So no matter where you're standing, it covers the whole room. Now, you can run it without the bass module, and they do sell it without the bass module, but it doesn't sound... Let me get back to that. Alright, here we go. Let's pick a different track. This is really old music, so it's not a really good demonstration. But there's no bass whatsoever without this. So you plug this in. Then it kicks in. And this has only got 2 4.5-inch speakers. I'm picking really old music, so YouTube doesn't pull the video down, because I know that these people are stupid. I'm not trying to steal the music. I'm trying to demonstrate a product, and these dumbasses flag videos. So, I just love these things. I have two of them. I believe in having two, so you don't have a single point of failure. The other thing is with two. Let me turn this down a little so we don't get flagged here. With two of them, you can do stereo, but I would recommend not doing stereo. I would recommend doing mono. If you had two of these and two subs, either two B2s or two B1s, the ideal thing to do is to stack the subs directly on top of each other. So that way the bass doesn't, you don't have canceling waves. If they're stacked on top of each other, it increases the effect of the bass. Also, moving the subwoofers around closer to a wall or a corner definitely increases this bass response as well. I don't know if I believe them 100% when they say that, you know, the B2 is equal to 4 of them, because that means I have 8 subs in a space that's about that high. You know, it's hard to believe. My next thing is I want to get into wireless, like a Bluetooth system. As a DJ doing weddings and stuff, I could run the entire show from the iPad. However, Bluetooth has a delay. There is a new form of Bluetooth out that has extremely low latency. The iPad does not support that format yet, so I'm waiting for that. And that would be really nice. That with a wireless mic, you can completely walk around. You wouldn't even have a station. You could just DJ that doesn't have any station. You just float around the room. Everything's completely wireless. What else? There is a guy on YouTube that actually sells a bracket that fits into this little groove right here. This little slot. And believe it or not, it's not authorized by Bose, but you can actually turn this into a light stand as well as your speakers. So
a little screw on top, and then he gives you a bar that comes out to about, you know, that far on both sides, and then you could take a light, and assuming you're balanced it, you could put lights on it. So now you have a stand, plus you have your speaker, plus you have your lights and the amplifier, all within one piece, which is really, really cool. That's one of the reasons I got 2 1S's instead of one. I did an entire wedding of 600 people, about 600, with one Model 2. And it was cool, but I don't know, I just want two. I think it's better to have two so there's no single point of failure. Plus you can also, if you have two rooms, you can always leave this in one area and this in another area. It gives you more flexibility of having two of them than just having one more powerful one. Now, one thing I wish they would let me do is, I wish you could plug this directly into the bass and not have this extension so this could sit on a table. That's not possible. The connectors are different, and I see no easy way of doing it. I found the connectors online, but I don't know. Probably not worth doing, actually. These are expensive little speakers. For under $4,000, you get a pair of them. And this is with the 8 sub equivalent, so you've got a lot of power that fits in the back of any small trunk. Doesn't have to be a van, or doesn't have to be an SUV, I mean, or even a station wagon. Conventional speakers, you've got yourself an 18-inch sub. It's back-breaking, it's a pain in the ass. These things fold up into two small bags. I think the subs weigh about 40 pounds each. Everything comes with slip covers for the subs. These scratch extremely easily. It's a very soft plastic, so get a cheap mat to put them on, because even just sliding them on the floor, it's going to scrape up the bottom. If you want them looking new, you know, this is metal, and this is the same plastic, metal and metal. So, some reason always seem to get scratched up easy. I don't know why. Ever since I've owned the Bose, all of them, it's just a soft plastic. The compact is good, but it just wasn't loud enough, and I had two of them, believe it or not. I don't know, there's just a difference in sound over Bose over conventional speakers, where I can actually sit pretty much right next to it and hear the same thing as somebody in the back of the room, which is phenomenal. I wish somebody would actually do some more information on how that science works. I understand that it the waveform, how it's aimed and everything, but I really would like to understand the physics behind it, because a traditional speaker is just a woofer and a tweeter, and Bose did it different. They're all these little individual drivers. I think it sounds better than any other speaker. Some people say all highs and all lows must be Bose. Well, I don't agree. I think what they're doing is, without the sub hooked up, it doesn't sound as good as it does. I mean, it sounds a little bit tinny.
In case you're hungry, give a little bit of whiskey.
Because I think what they're doing is they're substituting some of the mid-range frequencies into the sub. So I think the sub is very important. Do not buy one without a sub. Yeah, that's got to be what they're doing. Now, to that same thought, one of the reasons that people get a lot of compliments over the Bose is because most DJs, they basically have no knowledge of sound or engineering or anything like that, and what they do is they just bring these huge cabinets, 18-inch subs and 15-inch woofers and huge JBL. I mean, nothing wrong with Mackie or anything like that, but if you stand next to that speaker, it's blaringly loud. And when you're at a corporate function or a wedding or something, you know, very special, you don't want, it's not a club, it's a social gathering. And what I think the Bose excels in is the fact that the mid-range, where the human voice is not overdriven like it is with most speakers.
Yeah, you could use an equalizer on a regular set of speakers and probably cut down certain areas where the human speech range is. But why bother? I mean, you basically just want to get the beat, the bass, you want to hear the vocals of the music and the instruments, but you don't want it to be over blaring. And I think that's honestly why people get a lot of compliments with this type of technology. I don't think anybody realizes that that's probably the real reason. I've got to the point where I've actually started my conventional Mackies. I've actually started to turn the mid-range down, and I noticed that people can actually hold a conversation better, yet still hear the music, still feel the beat, you know? And Bose figured that out. A lot of money went into research. There's 10,000 people that work at Bose. It's not a small company. They've been around for 50 years. These people know what the hell they're doing. Yeah, and the stuff they sell is very expensive. It's not cheap. It's like the Apple of speakers. Ridiculously over-engineered. They spend a lot of time in testing and designing stuff. Whereas other companies don't care. They just want to sell you something, you know, sell you another set of speakers next year or whatever, just in for the quick buck. This line, L1, has been around since 2007, and they haven't discontinued it. In fact, they added more. They are coming out with another line array, but it looks more like a traditional speaker. It's coming out in August. I did not go for that because I think it only has 6 drivers instead of 12. It does have a woofer built in. It didn't have the stands built in and all that. I said, you know what, I want to stick with this. It's just an elegant looking solution. People say, where's the speaker? They don't even see it. Many videos on YouTube. I need to find some places to actually do some tests with this, with all different types of music. Pop, hip hop, jazz, blues, you know, a lot of different types of music. And right now, I don't have anything planned out, so I'm going to have to find another hall or something to test these out. So I know it's a long video, but I really think these speakers deserve somebody to take time and explain why these things are so damn good. If you've got the money, and money's no object, get yourself 2 Model 1 the full one, so they're like $2,000. Model 2, I'm sorry, Model 2s. This is the Model 1. Get 2 of them. But if not, next best thing is 2 1S's. Half the array, same bass. Actually, more bass, actually. If you get 2 1S's compared to 1 Model 2, you actually have more, you have double the bass than you do. That's another reason I went with the 2 1S's. Basically, spent more opportunities, more configuration possibilities, in other words. So, alright, so this is video 1. I'm going to do some more videos where I can actually turn this thing up. Unfortunately, the first video I did in that hall, it was like 150 degrees in there. I didn't have much time. So I just wanted to see how they sound and how loud they were, and they were loud, let me tell you. So this speaker here is not going to be part of the video. This is what I use at home and for small venues. I don't feel like carrying much. I bought that separately, and they're all interchangeable between the old models and the new models. All right, thanks for listening, and going about 20 minutes here.